Was können wir denn theoretisch bei der Bank tun? I regarded the bank as we entered. It was a place of stone and shimmering marble floors with beautiful windows, fountains and plants. You wish to withdraw funds, we were told. I warn you, it may take some time. 3000, wenn wir 1000 morgen kriegen, das wird uns auf jeden Fall... Na gut, wir machen das einfach mal. We require 1000 pounds, I said. The manager nodded. I will have to communicate with London first, of course. He apologized. I should have a reply tomorrow, it seems, Monsieur von Rather. We left some time to dispose of. Also, wir haben, da wir jetzt eh Zeit haben. Also, wir fahren bis dahin. Theoretisch nicht negotiate. Bla bla. So. Haben wir jetzt ein bisschen was bezahlt? Das machen wir jetzt aber auch. So. Das heißt, wir gehen morgen auf die Bank. Und uns nochmal ein bisschen Geld. Before going to bed, I did some minor alteration to our clothing. I ran a few errands for the hotelier. So. So, wir haben ein bisschen Geld gekriegt. So. Bank. So, wir haben 1000 gekriegt. Ich muss nur ein bisschen gucken, so. Wir schauen nochmal in unser Luggage rein. Was war nochmal gut in Edding-Dingsbumsburg? Ektarinburg. Ja, die 8 Dinger, die können wir uns ein bisschen schenken. Okay. Wir machen das wieder zu. Plan. Ganz ehrlich, ich glaube, wir fahren nach Irtrusk, weil zwischendrin die brauchen wir nicht wirklich. Und dieses Stück da allein kostet 600 Dollar. Ich würde, da können wir noch ein bisschen was dran tun. Und vielleicht können wir hier über Urga fahren oder so ähnlich und so weiter und so fort. Also, dann, haben wir dann nach Moskau? Na, kommen wir eh nicht mehr. Hotel. We made ourselves comfortable night and I starched the colors of our shirts, went to explore a little. And spoke to somewhat anarchic Moscow. Ah, das kennen wir schon. Gut. Dann, depart. Was habe ich jetzt gesagt? 1300 Etrusk. Was embarken wir? Higher extra sprays. Oh, Open Luggage. Können wir irgendwie... Was brauchen wir denn? So, da kommen wir gar nicht mehr. Das schaffen wir schon mal nicht mehr. Caribbean Timetable. Machen wir nicht. Und... So. Embark. Go. So, ab Transsibirien Express. The bell in the stuck coat and whitewashed Moscow station gave its third and final clang and the platform erupted into frenzy. Rush shale. Oh Gott. We boarded calmly and found ourselves in a small cabin with heated water and even a shaving mirror. Wait. Experimental hovercraft to launch from Yokohama soon. Oh! Das ist gut zu wissen. Ich schätze mal, das können wir benutzen. So. We were away. I was affixed to the window the first day, familiarized with myself with the train. Slay out, the last two carriages were heavily guarded prison cars, then fourth class, then third, and so on, with amenities shared between passenger cars. The candlelit chapel was presided over by long-bearded Orthodox priests and full of the prayers, and was positioned near the crew's quarters. I spent an hour listening to the murmur chanting and felt quite reassured. My bed that night's weight, along with the motion of the train from Moscow to it was a journey over 5,000 miles, and we had only just begun. So, converse. Greetings, Madame Pavlichenko. May I see your ticket? How I despise this job, Tusk. What can you tell me? Sounds unhealthy. Ich sollte das eigentlich kennen. So. Okay, denn da gibt's keine Bank. Ich habe keine Ahnung, wie die Namen alle heißen. So. Wissen was haben wir noch vor uns? Our fellow passengers were a mix of convicts, political radicals, prospectors, businessmen and military officers. In the midst of this way was a young lady, Rosa. Modishly dressed, wearing a bored expression. As she was harangued by her formidable mama. Boah, was ist das denn? I made her I ignored her. From her flouncing, I judged that she was having some kind of affair, and I did not wish to involve myself in any potential complications. We crossed the Volga in the early afternoon, crawling slowly over a bridge perched on high stone pillars. The devout Russians stood and crossed themselves while looking out over the water. I could hear the littling, rhythmic oar beating songs of the Volga boatmen over the whistle of the steamboats. Your character is now dependable. Das war vorher auch schon. Wait. Phileas Fogg attempts round the world adventure. Sehr schön. We crossed the Urals, also Deutsch ist es Uralgebirge, ich weiß es nicht. We crossed the Urals today, at the risk of sounding like a jaded traveler. I must admit that they are hardly magnificent. Heaving up of earth and forested hills for a few hundred miles. We stopped for an hour at Ekaterinburg, where I joined the lovely cavalry of officers as they ate smoked fish and played music to accompany their repast. One of them enjoyed me to play his balalaika, a kind of triangular mandolin. I accepted eagerly and strummed a few notes to familiarize myself with the unaccustomed instrument. Once happy with its function, I played a familiar favorite, a new Gilbert and Sullivan tune. which I had the luck to hear performed in Paris before I entered into Monsieur Fox's service. The officer struggled to keep up with the words, but upon a second repeat, nearly the entirety of the Ectarienburg station restaurant boomed out the chorus lines. In short, matters were trouble. The officers were so pleased by my performance that they very generously made me a gift of that very same balalaika. I cannot wait to play it for Monsieur Fogg. Gott, kümmern wir uns mal ein bisschen um Fogg. Wow. Hat nicht so viel gebracht. Wir kümmern uns doch noch mal ein bisschen. Und wir sind in Omsk. Time on board trains takes on meditative quality. I danced like a Khazar. I visited the library car. Is the library car? And met Goland, the daughter of a Mongol chieftain, was poring over a thick volume of algebra. I confessed myself surprised. I lamented my lack of mathematical skill, and she laughed. I must study algebra if I am to be an engineer in the Imperial Army of Russia. I wish to leave behind my ancestors' warriors' past. But you have a glorious history. It is a new world, I observed. We may remake ourselves as we like. She laughed delighted. Just so. She folded the book closed. You have traveled, monsieur. They call us barbarians, don't they? She asked. I felt sorry for her and wanted to soften the truth. They do. Who are they and what do they matter? I demanded, with the fine rhetoric and spirit. Your life is yours. She leaned forward, eyes shining. The truth is, there is more going on in my country than most outsiders know. We are growing fast as a people. What do you mean? You mean territorial expansion? I asked, nervously. What do you mean? I asked, intrigued. This is the age of progress, she replied, tapping her books. Of systems and thermodynamics. And my people, we have discovered some very interesting things. I was intrigued and leaned forward to hear more. But the girl shook her head. I won't tell you, she said and laughed. I will show you tomorrow night on the deck. I will be there. I nodded. We conversed until supper, and she presented me with her family's sword, a Mongolian horse tail banner. I do not have any need for my past where I am going. You have it. Do with it what you will. Okay, das gibt uns anscheinend ein bisschen Geld. Omsk today we descended a full score of British, Dutch and German merchants ourselves onto the platform. Nashans on took on more military officials who cleared an entire first-class carriage for the use of a mysterious couple. I caught a brief glimpse of them, but lost interest quickly. However, well off one is, there are always those doing much better. The hour grew late and my meeting with Goland, the mathematician, approached. Monsieur Fogg watched my bustling about our cabin with suspicion. You look as though you are planning an escape, he remarked. I'm meeting someone. I think perhaps I will stretch my legs. It is nothing. It is nothing, I replied, waving away his concerns. You have tied yourself a cravat, he observed. Shined your shoes. Is that my jacket? Passepartout, I do believe you are meeting a woman. It is natural enough past time. She knows about transport from Mongolia. Monsieur Fogg gave me a steady look. So now you are a spy as well as a wallet, he remarked. Perhaps you will find something of use. Having given me his cautious approval, he returned to his newspaper. I breathed a sigh of relief and hurried from the cabin to meet Goland on the viewing platform of the train. You came, she said. I am glad. You wanted to show me something. She looked me in the eye for a moment and looked away. Of course, yes. Taking my hand, she walked along the edge of the rail, the wind tugging her hair into a wild dance. The train's lamp was a single candle in the endless night. Lifting my hand past her cheek, oh god, das wird das hoffentlich kein Soft Porno, she pointed my finger out into the desert. There. I saw nothing except evening stars. I shook my head, and Goland laughed. There, she exclaimed. How many stars do you know that move? She was right. One gleaming dot on the dark horizon was lifting upwards. Goland squeezed my hand. That star is the Garuda launching, she replied. It flies at night to keep it a secret. But no, you know it. Was ist ein Garuda? What is the Garuda? I asked. The world has been made small by airships, Goland replied. They pull everyone closer together, but our Garuda is faster still. It will turn this world into a single teeming city, and Urga will be at this new world's heart. It sounds most formidable, I taught her. Es könnte sein, dass ich das ein bisschen Französisch ausgesprochen habe. Denk da so an einen gewissen Song von Stromae. Now you see why I am studying, she replied. Everything about this new world will be different, and I will help shape it. I do not doubt it. You will rise like that star. I do not doubt it. Flatterer, her eyes flashed with hot anger. A moment later, she stood on her tiptoes and leaned forward, and leaned forward. Out there on the deck of that remarkable train, with the endless Russian night bitterly cold, the lady of the steps kissed me. Okay, that's not successful, that's one of our own relations with Thug have strained. Strangeness. So, we have conversed with some greetings, Monsieur Nicholson. Now then, Passepartout. Etrusk. I am sure you know all about Etrusk. Have you heard that Beijing can be reached from Etrusk by freight train? Nein, das wissen wir jetzt aber. Ich frag mal wieder so blöde Fragen. Ich lese es mal nicht mal alles vor, so gerade eben wurden wir gefragt, ob wir nach Moskau fahren. Krasnodorsk. Aha, Krasnodorsk will major world capital. Keine Ahnung. Nach Peking kommen wir jetzt auch. Wobei ich aber glaube, dass wir eigentlich am besten die andere Richtung verfolgen sollten. At breakfast I was collared by an elderly officer with gold epoch. Gott. Zigzagged with silver, a major general. I started to make hasty apologies for last night's song, believing him to be gravely offended, but he only wished clarification on certain lyrical points, which I was only too happy to provide. As the sun set over the taiga, Monsieur Fogg expressed a mild boredom with the monotonous view from the carriage windows. My own feelings were quite different as I stared across that wild view, a view I liked so much that once night had fallen, I could not sleep, and was forced to take a turn around the viewing platform for the second night in a row. Fuck. So, von Itrost müssen wir uns jetzt langsam entscheiden. We reached the magnificent Angara Valley that holds the mining camp of Irkutsk. We disembarked as per our tickets. We looked through the window. There was nothing that could persuade us to disembark. We looked through the window and saw there was nothing here, barely a building of any kind. I began to doubt our plan, but Monsieur Fogg insisted that a ticket was a ticket. Ich wollte eigentlich nicht klicken. As the train pulled away, I wondered if we had made a terrible mistake. I saw Goland disembarking with a suitcase of books and struggling under the white. I rushed to her aid, but she brushed my help aside. Generous, sir, she murmured, but I cannot be seen to help by a Frenchman. I stood back, stung, and watched as she met a man on the platform, an uncle perhaps, who scooped her up with great familiarity and led her away to a horse, parked neatly in the yard beyond. Then she was gone. So, wir müssen mal ein bisschen, wir haben neue Routen. Interessant. Itrusk was a surprisingly beautiful town and packed with so many churches that one could not look up at any street corner without seeing a dome or steeple. We explored, entering the city across the bridge made of tethered boats. My acrobatic skills made the crossing easy, but Monsieur Fogg found it a most unpleasant business and, once across, refused to return to the other bank. On a street corner across the water, we saw a group of soldiers stop and turn to face the sun, praying bareheaded. There's a steady calm about this place. The people here act as though possessed. There's a steady calm about this place. The people are both devout and poor despite the gold that flows through the city every day, on its way to St. Petersburg. The barges of precious metal are fast. It's a wonder that there are no robberies and hijackings, also. But no good to us as they are heading the wrong way. I kept looking for Goland as we walked about the wooden pavements, but did not see her. I suppose that she had been whisked away by the horse caravan into the deserts to the south. Perhaps the sight of the mysterious Garuda would persuade Monsieur Fogg. Perhaps it was for the best. So, Nebenschwätzen. Plan. Itching can be reached by freight train. Das ist ja schön und gut. Wir müssen dann auch irgendwie nach Japan kommen. Vielleicht kommen wir von Peking irgendwie nach Yokohama. Da kommen wir Mittwoch an. Oh Gott.